Welcome to BTC Online Fam. Thank you for joining us. We are excited for today's message. Surely, this will leave an impact and make us love God next.
Collaboration is multiplication. Sabi mo, collaboration.
Collaboration.
What is collaboration? Ano ba yung sabihin ng collaboration or to collaborate? It means to work with one another or to cooperate. Nowadays, wala nang cooperation eh. You know? Wala nang nag-collaborate, wala nang masyadong teamwork. Ang nangyari ngayon is kanya-kanya. Nagsosolo. Amen. Ang dami ng mga tao, almost everybody, ang hilig magsolo. And you know what? It's always been on the heart of God that humanity would collaborate together. Ang gusto ni Lord, mag-collaborate tayo, mag-cooperate tayo. We work in a relationship. Kaya nga on Genesis, all throughout the Bible, makikita mo yun eh. In the beginning, in Genesis chapter 1, verse 28, habang ginagawa ni Lord, ginagawa ni God, lahat ng nakikita mo sa mundong ito, when He created, sabi niya, let there be light, let there be a separation between the land and the sea. Lahat ng ginagawa niya, He created the animals, sabi niya, it's good. Sabi mo, it's good. Lahat ng ginawa niya, it's good. Nung ginawa niya yung tao, sabi niya, it's very good. Amen. Tignan mo yung katabi mo. Sabi mo, you're very good. Right? Hindi siya nagdalawang isip na, parang mali yata ito. Ah. Erase. Nung ginawa niya tayo, it's not the mistake. Kaya sabi mo sa iyo mo, you are never a mistake. Sabi ni Lord, nung nakita ka, it's good. But you know, the only time that He says that it's not good, when He saw Adam on his own. Yung nag-iisa lang si Adam, sabi ni Lord, it's not good for man to be alone. So ano ibig sabihin nun? Ang ibig sabihin nun that sin is not the first problem in the Bible. Solitude is. Yung pag-iisa, yun yung pinakaunang problema. Kaya sabihin mo sa katabi mo, katabi, huwag ka mag-iisa. Amen. Meron ba itong wala kang katabi right now? Pwede bang taas mo yung kamay mo? Junel, wala kang katabi dyan? Tinatawag dyan na si Kereji, tabihan mo ako. We need to have always somebody. Amen? Papansin mo yun? Ako dati nung medyo bata-bata pa ako, ang hilig ko po mag-isa. I watch the movies on my own. Nakakalungkot. Una, naisip ko, masaya kasi wala makikipag-argue sa akin, wala makikigulo sa akin, wala makikisaw-saw sa akin popcorn. But you know what? In the end, ang lungkot. Right? Yung tatawa ka tapos naghahalap ka ng kakampi mo. Yung mga kasama ko sa sinihan, di nag-i-English. Di naitindihan yung joke. Ako lang tumatawa mag-isa. Walang nakagets. Parang misa, parang jo-joke ako. Di ba? Tatlo lang kami tumatawa dito. Feeling ko alone. No, there is a problem when you are alone. Because we can't do life alone. Sabi nga natin, no man is an island. Pag mag-isa ka lang sa isang isla, mababaliw ka. Nalala mo si Tom Hanks? Di ba? Kinausap niya na yung volleyball niya, si Wilson. Dahil siya na mag-isa, nakakabaliw. And have you watched that? Kahit nga ikaw, nanonood ka lang doon, pati ikaw naaning eh. Nabaliw. What do you mean? For 1 hour, walang dialogue. Ang marinig mo lang, yung alon lang. Walang nagda-dialogue for 1 hour. Nakakabaliw. Sabi mo, nakakabaliw. God knows that Adam needed a partner. Someone to collaborate with. Someone to cooperate with so that Adam can achieve God's purpose and vision for his life. Kaya anong sabi ni Lord? It's not good for you to be alone. Si Jesus, He prayed this prayer in Matthew. It's John. John chapter 17, 21 to 22. Ang prayer ni Lord, the last prayer here on earth, bago siya ipako sa krus, was what? Na Lord, sana i-unite mo lahat ng believers. Sana magkaroon sila ng collaboration. Sana magkaroon sila ng unity. Sana magkaroon sila ng cooperation. That's why we have life group. Amen? We are cooperating with one another. And not only that, yung mga life group, hindi po yan separate groups. But pag pinagsama-sama natin, we become a church. Amen. That's why we are here. Itong atong worship celebration, sometimes we call it cell celebration. It's like a reunion. Amen. Nakita-kita uli ang mga pamilya. Hello, are you there?
Yes.
You know, ang prayer ni Jesus before he left earth, before he was crucified, is that we will become united, cooperating, and collaborating with one another. Amen? You know, sabi sa Deuteronomy 32 verse 31, can put 1,000 to flight. Sabihin, isa ka lang ping, 1,000, pwede mong habulin, pwede mong patakbuhin, pwede mong takutin. And sabi doon, not just that, one can put 1,000 to flight, but two can just collaborate, two can put 10,000 to flight. Kung isa si Ping, kaya niyang patakbuhin, kaya niyang palayasin, kaya niyang habulin, yung 1,000. Pero pag dalawa daw sila, kaya nilang patakbuhin, 10,000. We get that? If you would think about it, math-wise, sino magaling sa math? Kapag isa, kaya 1,000. Pag dalawa, ilan lang yon? 2,000 lang. But sabi sa Bible, 10,000. See, that is the multiplication. That is the mathematics of God. It doesn't make sense to us. Amen? Are you there? Kasi ang mathematics ni Lord, it's not addition. Sabi mo, it's multiplication. Amen? That's why we are always better together. Sabihin, isang tao can help save 10,000. 1,000. Isang tao can help find their way back to Jesus. 10,000 tao. 1,000 tao pala. Labo ko. Do you get what I'm saying? Isang tao can help start up their new life with Jesus. 1,000 tao. Do you believe that? 1,000 tao ang magbabago through you. Sabi mo, through me.
Through me.
Pero may 1 tao lang, 1,000 na. But wait, sabi mo, wait. 2 tao daw can win, can change, can help find Jesus, can help their way find to Jesus, 10,000 tao. That is our vision, 10,000 people. According to the Bible, 2 tao lang kaya na. Amen? I don't know about you, but I'm looking around, I'm seeing more than 2 people. Hello? So if we're thinking, it's impossible, Pastor. Impossible, sinasabi ni Pastor, change our city. Gano'ng kadami ang tao sa Antipolo City? More than 1,000,000. Kaya ba natin yon? Sabi sa Bible, 1,000. 2, 10,000. What if ilan pa tayo dito? 210. 220. You do the math. It's not addition, it's multiplication. Amen. Can we give God a clap for that? Imagine what God can do through us if we would just collaborate. If we would just work in a team. Amen? Kung magko-collaboration lang tayo, can you imagine what we can achieve? We can achieve the impossible. That's the power of teamwork. Amen? Sabi mo, the power of teamwork. Again, lakas naman ang konti. Sabihin mo,
the power
of teamwork.
Parang
medyo watang karatila ito eh. If we want to change our city, if you want to win the world for Jesus Christ, sabihin mo sa tabi mo, lagyan mo naman ng energy. Come on, you need to be enthusiastic. You need to be passionate for this. Again, sabihin mo,
the power of teamwork.
I found this video. It's a short video. Let's watch this. It's the power of teamwork, and I hope you enjoy it.
Here we go! Yeah!
There you go. That is the power of teamwork. Yeah. Imagine mo kung mag-isa lang sila, di ba? Malamang nakain na yung penguin. Or maybe, magkakasama sila doon pero hindi sila nagti-teamwork. Lahat sila kain. Di ba? That's the power of teamwork. We can achieve the impossible. How can a bunch of penguins defeat a large killer whale? Sabi mo, teamwork. Sabi mo, collaboration. That's what it does. It does the impossible. It manages to do kung ano yung bagay na nobody will expect them to do. Amen. Do you believe that? And sino manonood ng basketball ngayon? Sino mahilig sa NBA? Ano yung chine-cheer yung team right now? 2 years ago, pag sinabi kong Golden State Warriors, lahat, woo! Ngayon, wala na. Sino mga Golden State Warriors dito? Yeah. Wala na. No? Anong chinchiyan din? Lakers. Yung lagi mga panalo, di ba? Yung may mga superstar. We always cheer that. Ano mo ako? Sino mga bandwagoners dito? Kung sino yung sikat, kung sino nanalo, doon ka lang. Yung lagi chinichiyan mo, woo, Lakers. Next year, woo, Milwaukee. Di ba? Next year, iba naman. Woo, Toronto uli. Right? Ako, I've been cheering a basketball team for almost 21 years now. 22 years now. And kahit ano mangyari itong team na to, I always cheer for that. I always root for that. I always watch yung kanilang mga games, even right now. Kahit na medyo natatalo sila ngayon, I always watch. I pay for that as well. Kasi sa TV ngayon, wala nang NBA TV, wala nang ano yun, no? So ang ginagawa ko, I watch NBA sa aking iPad. I pay like 49 pesos per game just to watch this team. Because I love this team. It's the San Antonio Spurs. Sino mga Spurs fan? Let me tell you, if you're not cheering for the Spurs, if the Spurs is not your team, maghanap-hanap ka na ng simbahan. Walang maiiwan dito, kami lang, ako lang. Tsaka si ating si Ate Rose, alam ko Spurs fan yun eh. Bili na kay Go Spurs eh, no? You know why I cheer for the Spurs? Tanong mo bakit? Because they are God's team. If you cheer for the Spurs, automatically, you go to heaven. Believe me, I just made that up, pero malay natin. Because I really believe this with all my heart that the Spurs are the God's team. They're God's team. Naniniwala kayo doon? Sino niniwala? Taas ang kamay. Tayo lang dalawa may iwan, Sean. Taka si Reggie. Yung sa likod, mga sip-sip. But I believe that Spurs is God, sa God team. Let me show you. Let me show you a verse. Kailangan maging biblical tayo eh, di ba? Baka magsabi sa atin, di biblical yung simbahan na yan. No, we are biblical. When I say that the Spurs are God's team, it is. It's in the Bible. Let's open up our Bible sa Hebrews chapter 10, verse 24 to 25. Sabi ron, let us consider how we may spur. Let me say it again. And let us consider how we may spur one another in love and in good deeds. Pwede mapalakpan natin si Lord. Sino mula ngayon mag-cheer ka na para sa Spurs? Because they are God's team. Amen? And if you want to have victory in this world, always cheer for whatever God is doing. Amen? Kung ano yung gusto ni Lord, dun tayo. Kung ano ang team ni Lord, dun tayo. Amen? Sino mga Laker fans pa rin? Wala na. I have the mic. Amen? This is biblical. No, I'm just kidding. Pero you know why I love the Spurs? Because they play basketball the way that basketball should be played. Right? Nakapunod ba kayo ng Spurs na game? You know, they call it a beautiful game. Ang sarap panoodin. Wala kasing, wala yung, oh, ako magdi-dribble for 24 seconds na mabigay lahat. Panoodin nyo lang ako. Tapos gagawin niya lahat, di ba? I-step siya ng madami-dami. It's foul. Tapos ang dami yung tumabay, lahat yung mga kampi niya nakaganyan lang. Nakaabang lang para sa rebound. Napaka walang kwentang game. Nakakatamad panoodin. But you know what? Yung Spurs basketball, napakasarap panoodin. And I abeno kung napanood na video, let's watch this. It's 6 minutes and I hope you enjoy it though. Yung panoodin nyo kung gaano aganda when people are collaborating together. Amen? And here's what happened. Bago may play yan.
So many times.
Bago may play yan. Bago may play yan. This is nung, I think, 2014. Sinong buhay na ng 2014? Sino nagfa-follow sa NBA ng 2014? Sino pinakasikat nung time na yon? Anong team? Yes! It's the Miami Heat. It's the super team. Nandun si Dwayne Wade, nandun si LeBron James, nandun si Chris Bosh. So dito wala kang pakialam. Nandun lahat yung pinaka-the best. Kaya sila puro, go Miami! Yung mga Lakers ngayon, dating Miami yon. Na dating Cavaliers. Na minsan, nagiging Golden State sila. You know, pero everybody was they think and they believe na ito magcha-champion ng Miami Heat. Everybody, wala na yan. Tumabi na kayong lahat. But here comes the Spurs. Sabi mo, the Spurs. With their beautiful game, they achieved what is impossible. Why? Sabi mo, collaboration. Let's watch this.
So many times we promote the individual. Oh, LeBron, Kobe Bryant, Kevin Durant. But then we leave out something that's really unique and special, and that's team and team basketball. I sat there and watched this team carve the Clippers up by playing basic, fundamental basketball, and it was beautiful to watch. It reminded me of my era, the way we used to play the Celtics, just smart and great basketball. And I'm happy that we are seeing it in America. You need to appreciate the San Antonio Spurs and this team, well coached. And I'm just, sometimes you lost the words. All you need to do is just watch this team and they'll say it all.
If you're curious about the game of basketball, you watch them play. If you want the glitz and glamour and all the dunks, you may be focusing on another team. And it's a credit to the organization, the ownership, R.C. Buford, Pop and his staff, and the players. Everybody's in the same circle, and they believe in it. They're not all seeking a lot of glamour and everything else. It's a great way to play the game.
The players that I'm having the privilege to coach have been incredible. And the fact that they allow me to coach them the way I coach them surprises me almost on a daily basis. It's a great group of people who, I always say, have gotten over themselves. They come to practice, they play the game, we win, we lose, we go home. And they do it wonderfully, and Timmy is the guy that's in charge of all that. You know, he sets the tone on the floor for our players, and our success, although all of us have a part of it here, those are the guys that get it done. And they're the most important part of what we do, and they've done it wonderfully. And as I said, win or lose, they do it with class, and they do it the right way.
And dicing the Heat up offensively. Just terrific ball movement, but more importantly, it's the body movement.
The Spurs, they don't get knuckleheads, they don't get clowns, they don't get guys with huge egos, they get guys who have to do what they're told to do. And you put it all together, and you're right, it's like, wow, how come people can't appreciate this?
Yeah. When you see the Spurs play, they've been together a long time, they know exactly what Coach Popovich wants, they have great spacing, but their execution is second to none.
And one thing you learn, you can't outrun the basketball. And San Antonio is great about, I have a shot, but you have a better shot. They break you down with their passes.
The San Antonio Spurs, they do what they do. They're going to move the ball. They're going to take the high percentage shot. Popovich going to call the play. They're going to execute the play. They're going to set picks. They're going to do all the little things. And they're going to win.
Colo swings it. Here's Corey Joseph. Selfish basketball. How about this? I was watching the whole time.
Spurs select Tim Duncan from Wake Forest University.
Selection in the 1999 NBA draft, the San Antonio Spurs select Emmanuel Ginobili from Argentina.
With the 28th pick in the 2001 draft, the San Antonio Spurs select Tony Parker of Racing Club Paris, France.
Okay, there you go. Pero palakpakan natin. God's team, the Spurs. I don't know about you, if you don't like that game, if you don't like that team, then you're not a basketball fan. You don't like basketball. See, yung ginawa nila, because that's collaboration, that's teamwork. You know, for 22 years straight, laging winning season sila, lagi sila nasa playoffs. If makikita mo yung kanilang standing against teams all time. Kunwari, they played 100 games, laging lumalabas, 80, panalo ng Spurs, 20 yung kalaban. They've beaten every team sa NBA. They have a winning percentage sa lahat ng team. That's impossible. Yung pinaka-nearest streak right now, they have 22 years of always in the playoffs. Ang pinaka-malapit na streak is, I think, 6. 6-year streak. Yun lang. And then, the Spurs. You know what I'm saying? Ito yung the rest of the NBA, this is the Spurs. Why? Because hindi dahil sa magaling yung kanilang superstar, hindi dahil sa maraming silang mga magagaling na players. No, it's not that. Actually, yung mga players na lagi nang sinasabi, natatanda na ng mga yan. Mga lolo na, atin yung si Manu Ginobili, di ba? Panot na. Kasi kababatok ni Tim Duncan eh. Nauubos, dadahan-dahan. You know why they always win? Because of teamwork, because of collaboration. Say mo, collaboration. Collaboration does the impossible. Amen? Sabi rin, may nabasa ako, completing one another is more important than competing with one another. Amen? Again, let me say it again. Completing one another is more important than competing with one another. Pwede bang pakisabi sa katabi mo? Katabi, kailangan kita. Sa kabila naman, tignan mo siya sa mata, Sabi mo sa kanya, katabi, you complete me. You know, we need to be that kind of church. If you want to do the impossible, because people are saying, what? You want to change Antipolo? You want to win Antipolo for Jesus Christ? That's impossible. And you know what? Only through collaboration, we can do the impossible. Amen. Why? Because we are created to collaborate. Yung pangalawang bagay, we are called to multiply. Amen. Sabi ko nga, the math of collaboration is not addition. It's multiplication. Sabi mo again, multiplication. Because multiplication or faith, it does not maintain. Faith multiplies. The first commandment given to us by God is what? To go and multiply. Humayo kayo at magpakadami. Be fruitful and multiply. Kaya some of us here, yung mga pamilya natin, ang dami nating anak, di ba? 6, 12. Sino ito, meron kang 12 na magkakapatid kayo? Kasi yun ang sabi ni Lord, go and multiply. Sinagpadami ang nanay ko, ang tatay ko, masipag. They multiplied. The first commandment was be fruitful and multiply. Right? And si Jesus, he echoed this. Sinabi rin niya ito doon sa may parable of the talents. Doon sa may Matthew 25. God called us to multiply. Ganito po nangyari doon sa story na yon. God gave, or Jesus, or the master gave, sabi doon, he is a traveling master. So iniwan po niya yung mga servants niya. Binigyan niya ng pera. One, he gave 5, the other 2, and the other 1. You know this story, right? Yung 5, pagbalik nung master niya, tuwang-tuwa siya, sabi niya, yung binigay mo sa akin, 5, master, ginawa kong 10. I've worked for it. I've multiplied it. Now, it's 10. It was multiplied. Yung binigay niya ng 2, sabi niya, master, I multiplied it. I worked hard for this. Now, yung 2, naging 4. And then yung pinakahuli, yung 1, sabi niya, alam ko kasing medyo malupit ka eh. Magagalitan mo ko kaya ang ginawa ko, tinago ko. Nilubog ko, hinukayan ko yung lupa, tapos nilibing ko doon. But it's still there. Ito pa ngayon, no? Medyo lupa-lupa lang, binigay niya. Ano sabi ng master? You wicked servant. Ang tamad mo, sabi ng master. And he was punished for that. Sabi, you get out where nobody, wala kang makakasama doon, where there is gnashing of teeth, you will perish there. Mag-isa ka lang doon. Lumabas ka. Not only that, yung kanyang iisa, binigay doon sa menong nag-multiply. In other words, God wants us to multiply. God is calling us to multiply. Sabi sa John 15:16, I think, that God called us, God chose us to bear fruit, to multiply, and fruit that will last. That is our calling. Magpakadami tayo. Hindi mo lang i-keep yung binigay ni Lord sa'yo, yung blessing na nasa'yo right now, it's not for you to enjoy. Amen? It's for you to give out so that God can multiply it. Huwag mong sarilinin. It's the same thing with the salvation that we have. It's the same thing with God's, with the relationship that we have with God. You don't keep it for yourself na ikaw lang. You share it, you multiply it. Amen? Are you there? We are called to multiply because collaboration is multiplication. So God created us so that we can collaborate. And God, He is calling us to multiply. Nag-gets nyo? In order for us to multiply, we need to collaborate. Sabihin mo again, collaborate. God calls us, created us to collaborate so that we can multiply. The only way that we can multiply is if we collaborate. Amen. Amen. Nandiyan pa ba kayo? Parang medyo na may mesmerize pa rin kayo doon sa Spurs. Hope, I guess not. But we've been talking about Nehemiah. Si Nehemiah, he was called to collaborate. He was created to collaborate because he was called to multiply. He was called for a great purpose. And just like you, we are all created for this one great purpose. And that is what? To share the gospel, to share Jesus Christ, to share God's love. Amen? There's no greater calling than that. Hello, are you there? Mas greater pa sa tinawag ka para kumanta lang. Sabi ko nga, ikaw ang pinakakawawang tao. Kung feeling mo, ang calling mo is just to sing. Hello? But God called you for a greater purpose. God did not call you para lang kumita ng pera. Amen? God called you for something greater. Hello? Hindi ka ginawa ni Lord. God is not calling you para lang mag-aral. Hindi ka tinawag ni Lord para magtrabaho, para magutom, para magbayad ng mga bills. No. God is calling you for a greater purpose. And just like itong si Nehemiah, he was called for a great purpose. So he was living in exile. Nandun siya sa may Babylon. Kasama niya yung mga mananakop nila. And he was serving the king. As a what? As a cupbearer. You know, I love Nehemiah because sabi nga, he's just a dude. Sabi mo, dude. Isang simpleng mamamayan lang siya. Natagatikim ng pagkain ng king kung may lason or what. Ganun lang siya kasimple. That's him. And everybody can relate to him. He's not a great person. Right? He wasn't born great. He wasn't born rich. He wasn't born a royalty. He's just a simple na tao na nagbibrief at nagsisipilyo once a day. Simple lang, sabi mo, simpleng tao. Just like us. And he is a cupbearer to the king, the worst job ever. And then one day he heard a report, news came out mula doon sa Israel that in Jerusalem, his father's city was in ruins. Sabi ron, the gates was in ruins, even yung mga walls is in cinders. Naging abo na, naging charcoal na raw yung mga walls doon, and nothing is there to protect them. To the point na yung mga kingdoms around them, they are being threatened every day. Kasi wala nang protection eh. Wala nang walls of protection. Alright? Just like what's happening in our country right now, that's what's happening in our society right now. People have no protection. Wala nang walls of protection. Yung mga families natin, nagibaan na. And si Nehemiah, when he heard this, he had the burden. Umiyak siya, he was broken. God's purpose for your life, sabi natin last week, is that God's purpose for your life will be birthed out of brokenness. Whatever breaks your heart, that's where God is calling you to. Amen? Whatever it is that is tearing the passion out of you, that is what God is calling you to. The question is, what breaks your heart? What is breaking your heart right now? And whatever breaks your heart is going to be attached to your passion. You may get that? The reason why, probably, that you're not so passionate. When we come here, you're not so passionate. You're not saying, amen. You're not worshiping. You're not dancing. Nakaupo ka lang. Nakatayo ka lang. Paupo tayo. Upo tayo. Natutulog ka na halos dyan. Why? Because you don't have any passion. You know why? Because nothing is breaking your heart. Maybe you're seeing the world around us and you're like, wala akong pake. I don't care as long as I'm happy. Right? What breaks your heart? Nehemiah's heart was broken. And that's where God called him. Maybe right now you're sitting there, wherever you are right now. Maybe you're listening, you're watching. And you're saying, wala akong pakialam. Or maybe you're thinking, you're seeing yourself na parang, ano bang purpose ng buhay ko? You're thinking to yourself, parang wala naman kwenta, walang saysay ang buhay ko. Pumapasok lang ako, nagkatrabaho lang ako, nag-aaral lang ako, and then what? Walang kagana-gana. You know why? Because nothing is breaking your heart. This morning, what happened? This morning, let God break your heart. Amen? Let God break your heart. Sabi ko kahapon sa mga leaders, you need to be expectant that God will do something. Amen? If you want to be passionate in whatever it is that you are doing, maybe in your school, you know why parang wala kang kagana-gana sa school? It's not about your grades. Result lang po yung grades mo, result lang ng kawalan ng passion mo. Right? You know why? Because nothing is breaking your heart. Wala kang aapake. You don't care. Pasok lang ako, I'm just there. Basta pumasa lang ako, okay na ako. And yung grades mo, nagtataka yung nanay mo, tataka ka kung bakit hindi lumalaki. But hindi tumataas, maybe ganun din yung career mo. For 20 years now, you've been on the same job. And nothing is happening in your life. And you've been praying, and you've been praying, pero walang nangyayari. You know why? Because you're not letting God break your heart. You're not letting God inside your heart. And he had this passion, this burden. Iniisip mo itong burden na to, pampahirap lang. But you know what? Yung burden na yon, the burden for the lost people, the burden for the broken people, that will elevate whatever that you are doing right now. Why? Because it's bringing passion. Yung pagkagising mo, you want to wake up, you want to go to school, you want to go to your work, you're excited. Hindi para magtrabaho. Dahil merong mga taong kailangan si Jesus doon sa school mo. And you're so excited. Ang part ng pag-aaral, yep, that's just part of it. But my ultimate goal here is to bring the gospel, is to bring Jesus Christ, is to be a blessing to my school, to my work, to my family. Amen? This morning, let God break your heart. Let God put the passion in your heart. Si Nehemiah, he was broken. He was crying. He was wailing. Hindi siya matulog. Hindi siya makakain. May tigawot na siya sa ilong. Are you there? Hello? But you know what he did? He waited and he prayed. And then, the moment that God presented an opportunity for him, he grabbed that opportunity. Sabi nung king, ano ang kailangan mo? Ang lungkot-lungkot mo, anong kailangan mo? Anong sabi ni Nehemiah? Send me back doon sa Israel and I will rebuild the broken walls. He wasn't crying about the walls. He wasn't crying about the gates. He wasn't crying about his enemies. He was crying about his people. He was crying about the people. You know, this book of Nehemiah is not about the walls. It's about broken people. There's a lot of broken people out there. And if you don't let that break your heart, nothing will. Believe me. That is the greatest ang tawag dito? That is the greatest motivation that you can ever have. If you want to be motivated going to work, na kahit na paulit-ulit lang, hello, good evening, can I help you? Yun ang lagi ginagawa mo sa trabaho mo, wala nang ginagawa, paulit-ulit na lang. It's time that God breaks your heart. Because there's a lot of people who are broken out there. There's a lot of families that is broken out there. And just like si Nehemiah, he did the impossible. God made a miracle through his life because of that brokenness. You know, if you want to have miracles happen in your life, let God break your heart. Amen? Let God inside your heart. Let him make you see. Let him make you feel what he is feeling. Amen? Nehemiah's vision is to rebuild the wall. And his vision requires collaboration. Whatever that God is placing to you right now in your heart, the vision, the purpose in your heart right now, you know what? You cannot do it alone. Building, rebuilding the wall, it's a big task. Can you imagine if siya lang mag-isa trying to rebuild that wall? Unang-una, he's not an engineer, hindi po siya mason, hindi po siya karpintero, isa siyang cupbearer, taga-tikim lang. Taga-nguya lang siya, taga-kain lang siya. Yun lang ang alam niyang gawin. But he had this burden and because of that burden, he was able to do amazing and great things through his life. Meron ang yung purpose. Amen? Amen. But you know, Nehemiah's vision to rebuild the wall will require collaboration. He can't do it alone. You know, rebuilding the walls of our nation, rebuilding the walls of our families, of our communities, hindi ko kaya mag-isa. Hindi namin kaya mag-isa ni Ping. Now, we need everybody. We need this church. And not only that, but we need to work together. We need to collaborate. Amen? Because again, collaboration creates multiplication. The question is, what's stopping you from collaborating? Because itong sinabi kong collaboration, it's not just for this church. You can use it everywhere in your life. Maybe in your marriage, kaya medyo nahihirapan ka, walang nangyayari, walang passion. You know why? Because walang collaboration. Maybe you need collaboration in your marriage. Maybe yung mga business owner dito. The reason why hindi umangat-angat yung business mo, you know what you need? It's collaboration. Maybe in your school, kung bakit ang hina, ang baba-baba ng grades mo, kung bakit yung mga projects nyo, yung thesis mo right now, hirap na hirap ka. You know what you need? You need collaboration. Amen? I'm not talking about collaboration na pa-copya. Work together. Learn together. You can always learn from somebody. Huwag mo isipin, kaya ko to, matalino ko, magaling ako. Tapos pagdating sa exam, nangongopya ka. That's not collaboration. That's cheating. Amen? We need collaboration in our lives. And there are four things according sa book of Nehemiah, according sa life ni Nehemiah, that we need in order for us to collaborate. This is what we need. Number one, what collaboration needs is a clear conviction. Sabi mo, clear conviction. What? Again, sabi mo, clear conviction. Come on, if you want to collaborate, if you want to win Antipolo City, your family, if you want to have change in our nation, sinong sawa? Sinong galit? Right? Parang paulit-ulit na lang nangyayari sa bansa natin. Nothing is happening. We need collaboration. Huwag mo nang iaasa kay Presidente mag-isa lang. He's old. And he's getting older by the day because of the problems because nobody is helping him out. Worse is, anayang pang tao is trying to bring him down. Ang isa lang ang gusto niya. For the Philippines to be great. No, ibang kabansa pala yan. No, for the Philippines na makabangon muli. Amen? Na mawala ang corruption. Mawala ang drugs. But instead of collaborating, ano ginagawa natin? Right? We are going against. Again, we need to collaborate. Amen? In for us to collaborate, ang kailangan natin unang-una is to have a clear conviction. Sabi mo, clear conviction. Hallelujah, it's getting louder. Mamaya, sana palakas sa palakas. Okay? A man with a vision will become a man on a mission. But you can't carry the mission to its completion kung wala kang conviction sa puso mo. What does conviction mean? It means that you are convinced. Totally, 100% convinced ka, this is what we need to do. This is what I have to do. And kahit na anong mangyari, kahit na anong nakikita ko, kahit mukhang mahirap yan, gagawin ko. Why? Because merong conviction eh. Amen? Pagkagising mo, I need to do this. I need to invite. I have to pray for these people. I need to help and bless and serve them. Why? Because they need Jesus Christ. I believe this 100%. We need to have a strong conviction. Sabi rin, it's a strong persuasion or belief, a state of being convinced. Are you convinced that people out there needs Jesus Christ? Are you convinced that the only solution to our problem is Jesus Christ? Yeah. Then you need to do something. Si Nehemiah, he had this clear conviction. Watch this. On Nehemiah chapter 2, verse 11 to 13, this is what he did. Okay? I went to Jerusalem and after staying there 3 days, I set out during the night with a few others. He came to Jerusalem. Dumating na sa Jerusalem and this is what he did. Itong pinakauna niyang ginawa, I had not told anyone what my God had put in my heart to do for Jerusalem. There were no mounts with me except the one I was riding on. Pagdating niya doon sa Jerusalem, ano ang ginawa niya? Nothing. Wala siyang kinausap. Anong ginawa niya? He rode a horse, a donkey maybe. And sabi rin, by night I went out to the valley gate towards the jackal well and the dung gate, examining the walls of Jerusalem, which had been broken down, and its gates, which had been destroyed by fire. Nehemiah did not show up in Jerusalem talking about his vision. Hindi mo nito bilang paghari-harian. Mahil kayo sa akin, may gagawin tayo. No, he went to Jerusalem at the day that he arrived. Anong ginawa niya? He investigated. Sabi mo, investigate. Before he initiated, he investigated first. Nag-ikot-ikot muna siya. Tinignan niya muna, nag-survey muna siya. The conviction in him compelled him to go out and do something. Key word here is do. Sabi mo, do. Hindi agad siya nagsalita. Right? Hindi siya agad nag-pose, ito gagawin ko, ito ang gagawin ko, ito ang dapat gawin ng bansa natin. No, he did not. Alam mo, ginawa niya? He did. Sabi mo, he do. He started walking through the walls of Jerusalem instead of talking. Because a lot of us, we want to change. Right? We want to change and we want to be a part of that change. Most of us, anong ginagawa natin? puro dada, puro ngawa, kulang sa gawa. Before you can even talk, you need to walk. Gawa bago ngawa. Amen? It's time that somebody stands up and do something about it. Amen? Yeah, sabi natin last week, you need to wait on God and pray. We've been doing that. But sabi natin, while you are waiting, you need to work. Amen? You need to plan. You need to do something. This is what Nehemiah did. He had the vision the moment that he came to Jerusalem. Anong ginawa niya? He surveyed the place. He was thinking of a plan. Nagpaplano siya. Hindi siya bisang salita-salita. Na. We need to do more of walking and less talking. That is maybe the reason why we are in this place. You know, that's the reason why we, our country is in a place where we are right now. Because ang daming nga. Puro ngawa, kulang naman sa gawa. Do you believe that? You know, it's good that you talk. It's good that you have, that you found the problems. It's good. It's good na meron kang burden. It's good that you're talking about the injustices of our society. But it's about time that we apply and do something about it. Huwag ka lang puro ngawa. Huwag ka lang puro rally. Huwag ka lang puro post. Post ka lang post about devotion mo, yung biblical mga verses na pinopost mo, but you're not doing nothing about it. There's no power in it. Amen? The question is, what are you doing? Tanungin mo yung tabi mo. Sabi mo sa kanya, what are you doing? It's not what you are saying, but what you are doing. Nehemiah did not come to Jerusalem to recruit people. Hindi siya nandun para sabihin, tara, gawin mo yung wall. But you know what he did? Gagawin ko yung wall. And if anyone is with me, come with me. He did not talk the talk, but he also walked the walk. Amen? Nagpunta po siya sa Jerusalem not looking for people to come and do the vision that God placed in his heart. He came to Jerusalem to apply for the job himself. I wanted to build the wall. I will do it. Hindi sinabing, I wanted to build the wall. You do it. Most Christians are like that. Yeah. We want the world to know Jesus Christ. Now you go, Pastor. You do it. Come on. If God placed that burden in your heart, it's not everybody else or anybody else's job. It's your job. Nehemiah is a participator in the vision. Why? Because he has his own conviction. Let's not become a people, a church who expect other people to do what we are not willing to do. Are you there? You know, our greatest example, the one that we are following, it's not just your leader, it's not me, it's not Pastor Carla, it's Jesus Christ. He is the ultimate model. Sabi mo, wow, model. Jesus did not only talk the talk, but he also walked the walk. When he says, carry the cross every day, he didn't say, carry the cross, I will watch you. You know what he did? When he says, carry the cross, he carried it first. Do you believe that? When God says, carry your cross, he is saying, carry your cross because I have carried mine. And not only that, hindi lang niya kinary, but he was crucified on the cross for our sins. He went the extra mile. You believe that? He will not ask you to do something that he himself hasn't already done. Yeah, he is calling you to a radical vision. But when the world, when the city, when my family, that's so hard. He's not just calling you to do that. But not only that, he did it first. You already died for us. You already died for your friends, for your families. He went further. Hindi lang niya kinary yung cross. He was crucified and died on the cross for us. Amen. Jesus Christ walked through hell so that you can walk into heaven. So don't ever think na parang hirap ang pinapagawa sa akin ni Lord. No, He did it first. And you know what? He did more. Jesus is calling you to go and make disciples. Let me tell you, it's not gonna be easy, but you need to have a clear conviction. You need to have a clear conviction to step into that calling. God is calling you to multiply. God is calling you to become an influence. I know it's hard, but you need to have this clear conviction right now. I believe, I am convinced that this is the only answer. This is the only solution to our problems. This is the only solution to your problems. This is my prayer this morning, that we will have this clear conviction in our hearts right now. Don't ever think that it's hard, hindi ko kayang gawin. But you know the meaning of hard? Alam niyo ibig sabihin ng hard? It's this, not impossible. Hindi ibig sabihin mahirap, hindi mo na kayang gawin. Amen? Anong sabihin na mahirap? Extra effort. Anong sabihin na mahirap? Just have a clear conviction. You know, rebuilding a wall, it's hard. But Nehemiah had a clear conviction. From being nothing, pumunta siya sa Jerusalem, he started rebuilding the wall. What does conviction have to do with my collaboration, Pastor? Because collaboration, it begins with you. It begins with you. Amen. It begins with us. If you want to be a part of a serving church, you serve first. Amen. You want to be a part of a generous church, be generous first. If you want to be a part of an encouraging church, then I want to come to my church and be encouraged. You know what? Be an encouragement first. Maging encouragement ka muna. And if you want to be a part of a church that is life-giving, na pag pumasok ka sa church na to, you will be filled with life, hindi puro problema lang. Amen? Who wants to be a part of that kind of church? Na yung church na lagi nakasmile yung nasa paligid mo. You know what? Smile first. If you want to be a part of a church that is life-giving, be a life-giving person first. If you want to have a good leader, be a follower first. Sabi mo sa tabi mo, you first. Sa kabila naman, sabi mo sa kanya, you go first. Nagkaturoan bigla. Ikaw muna. Hindi, ikaw muna. Sabi ni Pastor, ikaw eh. No. We go first. Sabi mo sarili mo, I go first. Ano ang kailangan nun? Clear conviction. Pangalawang bagay that we need for collaboration is compelling communication. Sabi mo, compelling communication. Sabihin mo, compelling communication. Kailangan nagagalit pa eh. Every God vision will ultimately become a shared vision. The vision that God entrusted to us is not just for us, for me. No, it's for everybody. The vision that God has given you, it's not just for you, it's for everybody. Amen? The vision that God has for your life is not just for you. And if tingin mo para sa'yo lang yung vision na yon, selfish vision, and it's not from God. It's not from God. But everything that comes from God, it's being shared. It's being shared. God blesses you to become a blessing. You need to share it. Tama ba? Come on, that is one of the things that we believe in this church. Bless the city church. Through me, God will bless the city. Yung sabihin, papadaluyin ni Lord sa iyo yung blessing. It's impossible na maranasan mo, it's impossible na matikman mo yung blessing na papadaan sa ibang tao through you. Do we get that? And you must share the thing that God has spoken to you. The problem with most vision, namamatay, lumalabo, is because you're not sharing it. Kinikimkim mo lang. And then slowly, it will die just like a fire, if you don't share it, eventually, yung palito mo, mauubos, mawawala. Amen? But if you start sharing the vision will become stronger, bigger. Can you imagine yung Spurs? If si Tim Duncan lang ang may vision to pass the ball, wala, siya na namamasa. Hindi sila mananalo. But everybody had that vision. Everybody was on board. Everybody was collaborating. I don't know kung paano nangyari yun sa kanila. But I believe somebody was sharing the vision of a beautiful game doon sa team na yon. And they began to be on board with each other. And they began to do the impossible. Amen? Do you believe what I'm saying? Are you hearing what I'm saying right now? You must share the thing that God has spoken to you because it will require other people for it to be fulfilled. Winning the world for Jesus Christ is a teamwork. It's only done by collaboration. Si Ryan lang, di niya kayang gawin yon. I know it's in his heart, gusto niyang i-win yung buong school niya. But he alone, he cannot do it. He needs a team. He needs a team that will work with him. And how do you share that vision? Paano mo sasabihin yun? Through communication. The vision dies because we fail in communicating the vision. You know this term, lost in translation? Parang may napad akong isang game. Alam niyo, kapag siguro sa school or maybe sa work, team building ginagawa niyo yun. Yung nakapila kayo, mahabang pila, siguro mga 20 kayong tao, doon sa pinakauna may ibubulong o kaya merong i-action. No? Si ipapasin niya sa kabila. Ay, yung pangatlo. Yung pang-apat. Hanggang sa pinakadulo. Anong mensahe? Ano ang kailangan gawin mula sa una hanggang sa dulo na wala na, lumabo na, why? Because there's miscommunication. You know the reason why relationship is so hard? Collaboration is all about relationship. You know why? Because of communication. Kino mag-aasawa? Sino mag-aasawa dito? Especially kapag mga long distance. Madalas nag-aaway-away sila. Bakit? Kasi miscommunication. Through text lang. Through emojis lang. Kaya wala pang emoji. Galit ka eh. Hindi ako galit. Kasi may exclamation point. Hindi masaya lang ako. Diba? Nag-aaway-aaway. Kahit nga magkaharap na kayo eh. Meron pang loss in translation. Sometimes you overread. Tamas yung kilay mo. Galit ka sa akin, ano? Right? Sino ito yung mag-aasawa once again? You know, they say that women, they speak 20,000 words per day. Kaya next week si Pastora pagpipreaching ko sa dalawang service. Let me say it again. Women, they speak 20,000 words per day. Ang mga lalaki, hulaan nyo, 7,000. Noong ang tatawanan yung mga lalaki, nagkakaintindihan kami. Tama ba? Kunti lang ako. Yeah. Oo nga. Hindi. Sige. Mga lalaki, ganun lang eh. Pero nagkakaintindihan kami. Ito yung mga lalaki, mga nakangiti. Nagkakaintindihan kami. Yung mga babae, parang, sabi nila. Tama ba? Yung mga babae, ang daming sinabi pag may tinanong kay Pastora, isang simpleng bagay lang. May tanong sa kanya, ang dami kasi ganito, kasi ganyan, ganyan. Kapag ano kasi ganito nangyayari, tapos ganito, yes or no lang. Tanong ko lang kung anong oras na. Ang dami lang sinabi, why? Because they speak a lot. I'm not saying naman that's a bad thing. They just want to communicate. You see what I'm saying? Yung mga babae at mga lalaki, they're two different beings. Sabi nga sa isang libro, women are from Mars and men are from Venus. Magkaibang mundo, magkaibang mundo. Hindi nagkakaintindihan. That's why it's so hard to have relationship. That's why it's so difficult to be in a marriage. Kaya mga single people, mamili ka, maigi. Amen. Huwag ka pasok ng pasok sa relationship. If hindi para sa'yo, hindi para sa'yo. Amen. It's so hard. That's why we need to have a healthy communication. A healthy relationship is built with a healthy communication. Amen. You need to communicate well. Mag-uusap talaga tayo dapat. That's what communication does. Collaboration falls short if we fail to communicate with each other. And this is what happened with Nehemiah. In Nehemiah chapter 2, verse 17 and 18, Nehemiah gave a short and concise speech. Pagkatapos niyang i-survey, pagkatapos niyang mag-isip ng plano, he talked to the people. Ito ang sinabi niya, "Then I said to them, you see the trouble we are in? Jerusalem lies in ruins and its gates have been burned with fire. Come, let us rebuild the wall of Jerusalem and we will no longer be in disgrace." Ganun kadali. You know, from this speech, we can find, I think, four things that Nehemiah did. Nehemiah communicated the vision well that we can learn from. Number one, he points out the problem. Tinuro niya yung problema. Sabi niya ron, "Then I said to them, you see the trouble we are in? Jerusalem lies in ruins and its gates have been burned with fire." Ganun lang. Sinabi lang niya yung problema. Pinakita lang niya yung problema. God's vision always wake people up out of their complacency. And sometimes it takes somebody, it takes one person to communicate to you para makita mo that something is not right. When Nehemiah said this, "You see the trouble we are in? Jerusalem lies in ruins and its gates have been burned with fire." Hindi ba niya alam itong mga taong ito doon nakatira? Si Nehemiah nga galing pa sa malayo eh. But maybe the reason why nothing is happening, nothing is changing is because dun sila, nakikita nila araw-araw, and for them it's normal, okay lang. They actually live through the rubbles. They actually live through constant battles. Sanay na sa problema. Sino dito, sanay ka na sa problema? Sino sanay ka na sa traffic? Wala Antipolo hanggang Makati, hanggang Ortigas. Wala ka nang pakialam kasi 3 hours. Sanhay ka na. And wala na yung burden sa'yo to do something. Kaya pag ikaw tumatawid, wala ka na rin pakialam. Kukunti na lang yung pedestrian, dito ka pa tatawid. Nakita mo nang no unloading and no loading, doon ka pa nag-aabang. Why? Sanay na ako eh. Amen? Wala ka nang pakialam. And sometimes, it takes somebody for us to realize the problem. Amen? It's no news for Jerusalem. They wake up every day to this problem. They don't have the urgency to even fix the problem. You know, without a God vision in your life, without people pointing out the problems, we start tolerating the problem. It's the same with other people. It's the same doon sa katabi mo. If you don't point out the problem to them, if you don't point out the problem to your life group members, they wouldn't care. They wouldn't see the problem. Ano sabihin nila? Eh, ganun talaga eh. It's just the way it is. Let me tell you this morning, it's not the way it is. It's not God's plan na tayo maghirap. It's not God's plan na para tayo mamatay sa kasalanan. It's not God's plan para tayo mag-away-away, para tayo magsisisihan. Amen? Are you there? But you know what? You can't change what you tolerate. You know, it's time that we wake up with the burden in our hearts. I'm telling you right now, listen. Sabi mo sa tabi mo, listen. You need to be broken enough that it wakes you up from your sleep. Pangalawang bagay, I'll be quick. Not only that he points out the problem, but he also described the solution. See, hindi lang puro problema pointing out the problems. Marami kasi mga tao, yun lang ang feeling mong tinawag ka ni Lord. Eh. Tinawag ako ni Lord para magturo kung anong problema. Para maging reklamador. Lord, Lord. feeling natin, yun ang trabaho natin sa bansa natin, magreklamo na magreklamo. Sabi nga nila, mga Pilipino, expert lahat. Tama ba? Nung December, expert tayo sa wildfires. Lahat, ang daming may comment, lahat merong mga solution, merong mga problema sinasabi. Nung January, naging what? Naging expert tayo saan? Naging volcanologist bigla tayo. Di ba? Pumutok ang taal, lahat tayo bigla naging volcanologist. Hindi kasi nagano yung ano eh, yung gobyerno eh, kasalanan naman ni presidente yan eh. Right? In a few weeks after, ano tayo, naging piloto bigla. Nag-crash landing yung sinasakyang aeroplano, helicopter ni Kobe Bryant. Naging expert ka bigla ngayon sa basketball, naging expert ka bigla ngayon sa pagpalipad ng helicopter. After a few days, naging what? Naging scientist ka naman. Naging doctor ka naman. Naging expert ka sa virus. Ang dami mong alam. Sabi mo sa mo, ang dami mong alam. Hindi lang po tayo tinawag just to point out the problems, but God is calling us to describe a solution. This is what happened kay Nehemiah. Sabi niya, you see the problems that we are in, Jerusalem lies in ruins. And its gates have been burned with fire. Come, ano ang solution sinabi niya? Ano ang solution na sinabi niya? Let us rebuild the wall. That's it. Sabi niya, ang problema natin, wala tayong walls. Anong solution natin? Let's rebuild the walls. Hindi ka lang tinawag to point out the problems, but you're also called to share the solution. That's what's happening around us. People are looking for solution, and you have that solution. You have the answer. It's time to share that. It's time to communicate that. Amen? Amen. And then, Nehemiah was appealing to their imagination. Let's rebuild the wall of Jerusalem. Maybe nung time na yun, nung sinishare na yun, everybody was playing in their minds ano itsura ng walls na yun. They beginning to see, Nehemiah was beginning to share the vision. The imagination was being played off. The question right now, what direction is your imagination running in? Saan direction? Dalawang direction lang daw yan. It's either by fear or by faith. When I'm sharing this to you right now, ano nararamdaman mo? Natatakot ka ba? Now what? I will become a life group leader. I will start building up lives. Yung life ko nga, hindi pa rin maayos eh. Or are you running in faith? I will build my life, Lord, so that others' lives can be built as well. You're saying, amen. I'm gonna be part of the solution. I will open life groups on April 12 to 29. Amen? So solution can take a nightmare and make into a God dream quickly. Amen? Pangatlong bagay na communicate ni Nehemiah is that he reinforces the reason. So sabi niya ron, let's go back to the verse. You see the trouble we are in. Jerusalem lies in ruins and its gates have been burned with fire. Come, let's rebuild the wall of Jerusalem and we will no longer be in disgrace. He's appealing not just dung sa need nila, sa basic need nila, that you will have a wall. Now, did you have a wall? Kaya mo na ngayon mag-plant ng mga pagkain. Kaya mo na ngayon mag-alaga ng mga kanin, mga baboy. Kanin, baboy tuloy. Baboy, manok, at baka. You will have all that you need. But not only that, Nehemiah was appealing to their pride, to who they are supposed to be. Nehemiah is saying that you are God's chosen people. And ngayon, because of those walls na sira-sira, before, kinatatakutan tayo ng kalaban natin. But now, pinagtatawanan tayo. Like most of us. Dati, kinatatakutan tayo ng kalaban. Why? Because we have this burden, we have this vision, we have this passion. Natatakot ang kalaban because the enemy knows that people will be saved through us, that people will be blessed through us. But because our walls have broken down, hindi na tayo kinatatakutan, pinagtatawanan na tayo, pinaglalaroan na tayo. And Nehemiah is saying, if only we can build walls in our lives, in our city, then, ano sabi doon? Then, we will no longer be in disgrace. Then, we will become once again God's chosen people. It's a greater motivation. Kasi pagkain, pag nabusog ka, ayos na eh. Just like blessing. Don't just want God's blessing, but want what God intended you to be. You're not here so that you will be blessed. You are here so that you can bless others. Come on, give God the best love for that. It's a higher motivation. And then lastly, hindi lang po niya pinakita yung problem, hindi lang po siya nag-describe ng solution, hindi lang niya na-reinforce yung reason, but he also clarifies the urgency. Sabi ron, let's go back to the verse. Verse 8. Because we will no longer be in disgrace, the next verse, meron ba? Hanggang 17 lang yata yan. And I also told them about the gracious hand of my God on me and what the king had said to me. I also told them about the gracious hand of my God on me and what the king had said to me. Meron ng favor ni Lord, meron ng favor ng king, and this is the right time. Binigyan ni nung king sa akin yung pera. Bumili na ako ng mga lumbers, bumili na ako ng mga simento. Kaya natin gagawin? Ngayon na. Sabihin mo sa tabi mo, now na. Nehemiah clarifies the urgency. Hindi niya sinabing one day, or the next generation, maaayos din yung wall na yun. No, Nehemiah says that everything is in line now. Let's do it. Let's rebuild the wall. He communicated the problem. He pointed out the problem. He described the solution, and he reinforces the reason. Then he clarifies the urgency. Now, let me point out the problem. There are people who don't know God. There are people who are lost out there. There are people who are broken out there. You know, let this problem disrupt your everyday living. Let this problem disrupt your conversations. Habang nag-uusap kayo ng kaibigan mo, bilang masisingit, ako, naalala mo yung ganito? Madami naghihirap. Naalala mo yung nagpakamatay last month? Sana wala nang sumunod. Hindi yung pinag-uusapan nyo puro katiktokan lang. Hindi puro kaartehan lang. Dati usong-uso ang vloggers. Ngayon, TikTokers na. Ilang pinopost mo. You know, let this burden occupy space in your Facebook. Hindi yung puro mukha mo lang nakikita ko. It's time to share the vision. Why? Because may problema eh. It's time that just like si Nehemiah, that you will weep, that you will sleep over this, and hindi ka makakatulog. Hanggang hindi mo na dadala yung magulang mo, yung mga kapatid mo, back to Jesus Christ. The problem is, there are a lot of people who doesn't know God. Now, let me describe to you the solution. Sabi mo, build. We need to build and be the church in the middle of the ruins, in the middle of the problems. Amen? Na hindi lang po tayo nagtatago dito with our curtains closed, but we will go out there into the night, into the dark city, and we will start pulling people out into the God's light. Amen? That is the solution. Let's build a home for the broken. Let's bring back home those who are lost. And let them hear the gospel and let them have a relationship with Jesus Christ. Now, let me reinforce the reason. This is the reason why you are saved. This is the reason why you are born. This is why the reason why you are called. There are people that God had in mind when God saved you. Alam mo ba yon? God did not save you para maging komportable kang nandito. God did not save you dahil gusto ka lang niyang i-save. No. When He saved you, He had your family in mind. When He saved you, He had your friends in mind. When He saved you, He had your classmates, your workmates, yung mga kapitbahay mo in mind. When He saved you, He had yung nagtitinda ng Scrabble dyan sa baba in mind. See, God saved you for a bigger purpose, for a bigger reason. Not just to bless you, but so that others will be blessed through you. Amen? There's a reason why God saved you. Come on, give God the best clap. You are not just called for this, but you are born for this. This is your purpose. Amen. It's time to receive that. It's time to believe that. And lastly, let me clarify the urgency. It's right now. It's not tomorrow. It's not next week. It's not next month. It's not next year. It's right now. Pwede mo pa sabi sa mo, it's right now. I believe this. God is working behind the scenes. There's a reason why na nakuha niyo yung lugar na to. Sa murang mahalaga. There's a reason why we are in this place. There's a reason why you are in this place. There's a reason why you are doing what you are doing. You are experiencing. There's a reason why the blessing came your way at this time. The time is now. I believe that the city is ripe. Hinugna. I believe yung family mo, hinugna. I believe yung mga classmates mo, hinugna. Kailangan mo lang i-invite. They're just one invite away from hearing the gospel of Jesus Christ. I believe that there is God's favor working in us right now. Time is now. Sabi mo, now is the time. It's time to build. Amen? Come on, it's time to build. Sabi mo sa mo, it's time to build. Sa kabila naman, sabi mo sa kanya, it's time to build. And lastly, collaboration requires. Ano yung pinakauna once again? It requires a clear conviction. Pangalawa, what? Compelling communication. And then, lastly, constant conflict resolution. You know, there's so many blessings and benefit of a community, of a church, of a family. But we here believe that every blessing, there's always a burden attached to it. Hindi laging malinis na blessing, laging masaya, no. Minsan laging merong burden na kasama. And it's really hard to live in a community. That's why most people, they tend to be on their own. Ako, the reason why I'm always alone, kung ba't ako nanonood ng sinimang mag-isa, because I don't want to hear other people saying, huwag yan, iba panoodin natin. Ito gusto ko eh. Right? Because relationship is hard. Ang hirap makipag-relationship. Ang hirap makisama sa isang community, because in a community, community is all about people. And the more people, the more arguments, the more problems, the more conflict, the more opportunity na masaktan ka, na ma-offend ka, na ma-disappoint ka. Kaya most people iniisip nila, ako na lang mag-isa, para wala akong masaktan, para hindi ako masaktan, para hindi ako ma-disappoint. Ako na lang, pakasalan ko sarili ko, i-date ko sarili ko. Tama ba? Ayoko na mag-life group. Nasasaktan lang ako, na-disappoint lang ako eh. Hindi lang ako sinisipot. Ayoko na mag-consolidate. Diyan na lang akong upo na lang ako sa pinakalikod. Maybe kaya wala ka ngayon kasi wala tayo sa cinema. Dahil sa cinema, kahit mag-isa ka lang sa likod, wala nakakapansin sa'yo. Ang dilim na, nakablock ka pa, nagbilad ka pa sa araw. Nakikita ka lang kapag dimindilat ka. But now we are moved into this place. Everybody can see everybody. Ayaw mo na pumunta ngayon sa church. Why? Because people can notice me. Kukulti nila ako mag-life group. Kukulti nila ako mag-belong sa family. Ayoko eh. Ayoko masaktan. Maybe some of us here, naranasan mo yun. And that's what you're thinking. But you know what? Constant conflict arises. Laging may conflict. Laging dumarating. The problem is, we never resolve it. Bakit? Maybe you're like me. Kapag may conflict, tinatalikuran mo. Pag may conflict, hindi mo na nire-resolve. Ayaw mo lang kausapin. Tama ba? Kaya kadalasan, si kuya, si ate, si cell group leader, si life group leader, sinisinsone mo lang. Si pastor, hindi mo na mini-message. Nag-message ka, hindi mo na nireplyan. Why? Because you don't want to resolve the conflict. That's why we think that we are better off living in isolation. Let me remind you this morning that the blessing of community far outweighs the burden of community. Kung naiisip mo, mahirap kasi to belong in a community, masasaktan ako, mahihirapan ako, madidisappoint ako. But you know what? The blessing of a community, it's much more greater than the burden that you will experience. Wala ba akong sakit? Nakita ni Nehemiah when he came back to Jerusalem, they were about to build the temple, the walls. Alam mo, napansin niya yung mga elders, yung mga leaders, pinaperahan pala yung mga tao, pinapautang nila, tapos ang laki ng tubo nila. Hindi po sila nakamotor, wala po silang turban, magkakasama lang po talaga sila. And they were, itong mga leaders, itong mga elders na to, itong mga nobles ito, were taking advantage of the people. Anong nangyayari ngayon? Nagkakaroon ng separation, nagkakaroon ng conflict. And this is what Nehemiah did. On verse 6-7 ng chapter 5. Sabi na, when I heard their outcry and discharges, I was very angry. Nagalit kasi may burden si Nehemiah. He wanted to build the wall. Kaso nga lang, itong non-collaboration na nangyari, itong conflict na nangyari, it's stopping him from doing so. So he was angry. Then in verse 7, sabi niyo, I pondered them in my mind. Pinag-isipan niya. And accused the nobles and officials. And I told them, you are charging your own people interest. So I called them together, a large meeting to deal with them. Sabi mo, deal with it. You know, the only solution to conflict is dealing with it. Head on. Huwag mo nang isipin na mawawala din yan. Pagkakalimutan lang din yan. Alam mo yung mga pain, yung mga hurt, the more that yung pinapapatagal mo, lalong lumalaki. Parang sugat. Sometimes, akala natin yung sugat, pag hinayaan mo lang yan, gagaling din yan, hayaan mo lang yan. Mga lalaki, ganyan, di ba? Ayaw natin pagaling, ayaw natin lagyan ng alcohol, ng gamot, ayaw natin i-bandage. Hindi, okay na yan. Thinking, nagagaling siya eventually. But we here believe siya, pag hindi mo pinagaling, pag hindi mo nilinis, hindi mo ina-alcoholan, hindi mo nilagyan ng ointment, hindi mo nilakpan, we here believe siya lalong lalalayon. Do you believe that? It's true. Most people, noong World War II, pinuputulong kanila mga paas because ayaw nilang pagalingin, they keep on fighting. Ano nangyari? Nagiging gangrene, tumakalat yung infection. To the point, na unlitate lang yung sugat, kagat na ng lamok. It took out his whole leg because of that. Amen? Conflicts are to be resolved. Hindi po para iwasan natin. Nehemiah, sabi niya ron, he called out the meeting. I call together a large meeting. Sabihin mo siya, tabi mo, let's meet. Maybe some of us here, the reason why, hindi natin magawa-gawa yung kailangan natin gawin because we have conflicts with each other. Maybe some of you here, meron kang tampo. May tampo ka sa leader mo, may tampo ka sa katabi mo. Hindi mo lang sinasabi, you're just letting it pass by. Hinahayaan mo lang. But you know in your heart, na as the days goes by, as the night goes by, palaki ng palaki, pasakit ng pasakit yung nararamdaman mo. And that's why walang collaboration, walang teamwork. You know, si Kobe tsaka si Shaq, sabi nila, they could have won 5 more championships. Kaso nga lang, ano nangyari? Nagkaroon ng conflict. Nag-away sila eh. They were fighting. Who will get the ball? Kung sinong shoot? Pinag-aawayan nila bakit? Kasi hindi kasi na God's team eh. Hindi sila Spurs. So ano nangyari? Instead of winning more championships, nag-split together sila. Instead of doing the impossible, winning 5 straight championships or 7 straight or maybe 8 or 10 more championships, ano nangyari? They stopped working. They stopped collaborating. You know, maybe the reason why nahihirapan pa tayo, maybe the reason why yung katabi mo may bakante pa rin upuan is because we're not working together. We're not collaborating because we have pain. We have hurt. Meron pa rin tayong bit-bit na galit sa katabi natin. Si Nehemiah, he was angered. Nagalit siya. You know, there's two kinds of anger. The righteous anger and the unrighteous anger. You know, righteous anger is when you control it. Yung unrighteous anger is if you don't control it. Si Nehemiah, he had this righteous anger. He controlled it. He did not just react, he responded. And he dealt with it. Let me tell you, conflict, it's not bad. Everywhere you go, schools, trabajo, in your families, even in churches, we have conflicts. Why? Because churches is made out of people. And whether there's people, there's always conflict. The conflict is not the problem. The problem is we don't deal with it. We don't have conflict problems. We have unresolved conflict problems because we're not dealing with it. You know, resolved problems will make you stronger, will make us stronger. Don't ever think that if I tell this person I'm bothered by the way you look, I'm bothered by what you've said to me. Kung hindi masasabihin yan, marami pang tao masasaktan. Right? But if we deal with the problem, we have healing, we will become stronger. We will become more united, more collaborated. Resolved conflict will make you stronger. But unresolved conflict will make you toxic. Amen. Every relationship, what I'm saying is every relationship has conflicts. Marriages has conflicts. Siblings, they have conflicts. Families, they have conflicts. Classmates, schools, they have conflicts. Church, we have conflicts. Amen. But we need to learn how to resolve this conflict. Because the enemy knows it. The enemy knows this. Sabi ni Jesus that a house divided cannot stand. And that's the enemy's tactics. Hindi para bigyan ka ng mahirap na bagay. No, hindi niya gagawin yon. Because he knows that if you get offended, if you get hurt, you'll do much more damage. We need to decide today that we will become people who will always choose forgiveness. We need to become a church that will be forgiving. Amen? Hindi mo na kailangan pa maghintay. Sabi ko nga kanina, we go first. Sabi ko nga kanina, you go first. We are called to multiply. We have to collaborate to multiply. And you know, itong sinasabi ko, just like any story in the Bible, it always go back to Jesus. You see Jesus in the book of Nehemiah. It's in the Old Testament. You know, si Jesus, he wasn't just saving you from our sins. He wasn't just saving us from our sins and getting us into heaven when he was crucified on the cross. Jesus was also restoring our ability to collaborate with God and with each other. Because sin took that ability to collaborate from us. In the Bible, in the Genesis, yun yung unang ginawa ni Lord, they were collaborating with each other. God was walking around in the garden. And God made everything, right? He made the animals. And you know what God did? What God said to Adam? Alright, ginawa ko yung mga hayop na yan, ngayon pangalanan mo. God can do it. And I bet He can do better. Right? Hindi niya siguro tatawagin dog, yung dog. Maybe something else na mas magandang pakinggan. But God said, no, I made this now. You collaborate with me, teamwork with me, ikaw magpangalan. Because God always want to have relationship with us. God was always want to throw us where He is working. God wants to collaborate with us. Kaso nga lang, because of sin, nawala na yung collaboration na yun. And even with Adam and Eve, sabi sa Bible, hindi kayo magkakasundo. Why? Nawala na yung ability of collaboration. But God's heart has always been about collaboration. And Jesus, He not only restored our ability to collaborate with God when He was on that cross, hanging on the cross, dying on the cross, bleeding to death on the cross. Hindi lang po niya inayos yung collaboration between us and God, but He also fixed a collaboration between us together. So that hindi na tayo mag-aaway-away. Ano yung sabi ng prayer kanina ng Jesus? That we will be united, working, cooperating, collaborating with each other. Amen? And si Jesus, He modeled this while on the cross. You know, I believe this, that we are the reason. Kanta dati ito eh, we are the reason that He suffered and died. We are the reason that He is bleeding to death on that cross because of our sins. We are the reason why kailangan siyang paluin 39 times ng Roman cattails. Kung bakit kailangan siyang gulpuin, bakit kailangan siya lagyan ng crown of thorns. We are the reason. Sabihin mo sa tayo mo, you are the reason. It's because of our sin. That's why Jesus was crucified. Kaya nga sabi sa Bible, but while we were still sinners, Jesus died for us. Nagigets yung ibig sabihin nun? That's why on the cross, yung 7 last words niya, isa sa mga sinabi niya, Father, forgive them. For they do not know what they are doing. Jesus was hanging on the cross. And He is saying, no, patawarin niyo sila. Even before pa tayo ipanganak, sinasabi rin na Lord, patawarin niyo siya. Lord, patawarin niyo si Kuya Nals. Patawarin niyo sa Kat. Patawarin niyo si Marvin. Patawarin mo si Hillary. Even before you were born, God, Jesus, already forgiven you. Amen. What does that mean to us? While we were condemning Him on that cross, He is forgiving us. He was modeling. Anong ibig sabihin noon? Na hindi mo na kailangan pang maghintay na magsabi sa'yo, sorry. Forgive mo na. Father, I forgive them. Kahit hindi pa siya nagso-sorry. We need to be a church na proactive, na hindi ka na naghihintay na Lord, forgive them. Na Lord, sana mag-sorry sila. Huwag mo nang hintayin pang lumaki ang problema to the point na ang relationship mo with each other nasisira na. Maybe some of you here, yung nararamdaman mo. You have unforgiven sins. You have unforgiven problems. Maybe may nasaktan ka o maybe ikaw mismo nasaktan ka and hanggang ngayon, hindi ka pa yung nagsosorry o hindi pa rin siya nagsosorry sa'yo. It's time that we say, I forgive you. I forgive you. You know why marriages fail? Yung mga mag-aasawa, alam nyo to. Kasi 10 years ago na, binabalik-balikan mo pa. Naalala mo dati? Naalala mo 20 years ago nung ginawa mo sa akin ito? That was 20 years ago. It's time that you move on. It's time that we forgive. Maybe some of us here may nararamdaman kang ganon. Maybe against each other right now. If you want to win the city, if you want to rebuild the wall of our families, of our communities, dapat dito pa lang tayo, we are already forgiving. Dapat dito pa lang tayo, we are collaborating. The reason why we don't collaborate is because may sakit ka, may hinanakit ka dun sa kapwa mo eh. Ayaw mo siya nakikita. Naiinis ka, nag-worship pa siya, alam mo may ginawa siyang kasalanan sa'yo. Babagsak din yan. Mauubos din ang 12 niyan sa mga kasama ng ugali. You know, it's time that we forgive each other.
Thank you for being with us. We want to see you in person next week. Don't forget to like, follow, and subscribe to get the latest updates. God bless!